are some people on the way. Once again, it's Thursday evening. Seven people. Let me just give you a moment or two so that people can come in from clapping for the NHS. I hope you've got your hymn books ready. I did put the list of the hymns up. It's Ascension Day today. Not that we actually do a lot about that in the Methodist Church, but just put this camera a little bit slightly. Not that we do a lot with Ascension Day as such, but as a glorious hymn, Hail the Day That Sees Him Rise, Alleluia, which is 197 in Hymns and Psalms. I haven't looked it up in the other two books. How remiss of me. But I'm sure you can find it, or find it somewhere, or look it up on the internet. So, let's make a bit of a start then. 197 in Hymns and Psalms, Hail the Day That Sees Him Rise. quite a sort of longer hymn, putting all those alleluias in, and it does break the thread of the words. However, it's a great triumphant hymn. So, moving on to the Saviour when to heaven he rose, 211 in hymns and psalms. I was looking up sort of hymns that were appropriate for ascension, and this is one that turned up. So let's do that then. That, if we don't want that, and we certainly don't want that. Let's try that again. The Saviour when to heaven he rose, 211, the wonderful tune Gone Fallon Royal. Hymns where you need to put an amen on, otherwise you don't finish in the right place, or you don't finish in the on the home chord, if you like. And that is important, that we actually sort of feel that the hymn is actually finished off. I know I played, I went and played for a soloist at a wedding. I can't quite remember what the place was, but the words on the order of service weren't printed quite correctly for "Make me a channel of your peace." And there's the middle bit, isn't there? Oh, master. Da, da, da.
Thank you.
Brokenness stopped. And I was dying to go across and go. So we actually finished off, which was a bit of a shame, really. But it's one of those things that would, you can't sort of stop on that particular chord, because it wants to go somewhere else. It either wants to go, don't forget the test will be coming up, perfect cadence when we finish off the piece, and there's often a sort of formulaic ending to things, but we just stop there. I had a head of department at the school which I taught at in one place, and head of department, I could wind her up by just playing a chord which needed resolving. That was a wonderful tune, wasn't it? And Percy Buck wrote that. I owe a lot to Percy Buck. Never met him, but he wrote an organ tutor called The First Year at the Organ, and that was my tutor book, which I used. I don't know if it lasted for a year or what, but it's certainly a very, very, well, a good book. I worked through it, and I seem to be able to play the organ all right, so there we are. So Percy Buck's wonderful tune and his wonderful book, The First Year at the Organ. So going back in time, I'm in the wrong book. Still in Hymns and Psalms, 772, Jesus thy wandering sheep behold, 772. Hymns and Psalms. And I'm going to do it to the tune Elim brackets Hesperus by Baker Hereford, which we could sing to it. I will always associate that with something else. I've forgot what the words are. There we go. Jesus, thy wandering sheep behold.
Thank you.
where it shouldn't have done. There we go. These things happen. So I'm going to move to the old Methodist hymn book now, MHB. I know there's one before that. And I'm going to turn to 414. We thank thee, Lord, for this fair earth, the glittering sky, the silver sea, for all their beauty, all their worth, their light and glory come from thee. And it's been yet another beautiful day. I am told, though, that in Scotland it's been rather damp, and they're going to get some really wet weather up there. Of course, we could do with some for the gardens, but it's much cooler this evening. So we thank thee, Lord, for this fair earth. And we'll do it on something sort of fairly bright. And the glittering sky, the silver sea. Childhood memories of that hymn. I can't think why. Perhaps it was a hymn that we used to sing quite a lot, or it was a tune that I learnt perhaps at a younger age. I can't quite remember. But rather nice, lovely words there. 432, Hark my soul. It is the Lord, 'tis thy Saviour, hear his word. Jesus speaks and speaks to thee, say, poor sinner, lovest thou me? See what we can. 432, the tune St. Bees by J.B. Dykes. house in Wales, I think, on the coast there. So I could be making that up. Wonderful poetry in that hymn. And so I'm going to finish this evening with a, I had a request for this on Sunday, and it was really just a bit too late to fit it all in, and that is Beauty for Brokenness, which is 693 from Singing the Faith. I'm going to finish with that this evening, Graham Kendrick's song. As I told you, request from Pauline Beer, who attends Campbell Westley, and very sadly they lost one of their congregation, two of their congregation, in sort of in difficult circumstances. So this is thinking with them in mind. Beauty for brokenness, hope for despair, Lord, in your suffering world, this is our prayer. Bread for the children, justice, joy, peace, sunrise to sunset, your kingdom increase.
Thank you.
that's a great favourite of Margaret Barnes as well. And I was thinking earlier, it's one of those awkward page turn ones, so there we are, but it's a beautiful hymn, super words. Well, that wraps it up for the evening. Thank you for listening. It's been an interesting evening. I've listened to an organ recital from the largest church pipe organ in America, West Point at the Academy. It's got some 23,000 pipes and 874 stops, if you're into those statistics. Over 23,000 pipes. It's quite a lot. Truro Methodist has about 2,500. That's enough. And it's got about 45 stops. So, begs the question. It does lots of things. Must be nice to have 874 stops, I suppose. You can just use a few of them each week and not wear anything out. 23,000 pipes to tune. And, of course, one thing... go on too long. One thing that I did go to America to play, the first thing you did when you went into church was not turn the heating on, but turn the air conditioning on to cool the place down so that the organ sort of came into tune. So there we are. Fortunately, my electronics here don't require any tuning as such. 23,000. So thank you very much for your company this evening. Keep your requests coming in. I will be here on Sunday evening to play again hymns, and you never know, I might dream up something else. I have been experimenting with the organ setup, and it will do something other than be a church organ, so we have to see what happens. But as always, do take care, stay safe, and good night, and God bless.